Hello guys, in this video I'm going to try and repair a graphics card that has some corruption issues. Hopefully you can see the corruptions. In higher resolutions it mostly doesn't even display an image, only in lower resolutions. Let us start in safe mode. So no drivers are really involved into this situation, so you can see exactly the problem, and I'm going to try and fix it by using a heat gun, and if that doesn't work I'm going to try and bake it a little bit in an oven. Well, hopefully the heat gun will fix the problem, as that is a little bit easier to use. I've seen a lot of discussion in forums. You can see the corruption clearly now. Videos on YouTube. This will probably not be an final fix. This will most likely work from a few months to a few years. But yeah, that's what I need at the moment, a graphics card that is working. So yeah, I'm going to shut it down, take the card out, show you exactly what's about, and start the process of trying to fix it. This is the graphics card, heatsink removed. It's a 7300 GT from Nvidia. Of course, it's a low power graphics card, but yeah, better try this kind of stuff on cheap low power cards. And I'm going to do some tests on this to see how fast the solder will melt. Of course, not the same type of chips, they have the contacts on the sides, but at least it gives me some information, because I have no idea how much I need to keep this thing running. So yeah, probably I'm not going to do this on video, because I'm not exactly sure how I should do it, but it will be something like this, and going all around and heating it up evenly, and I will do my best to try and look with some light from the side to see when the solder melts under this chipset. But yeah, not really sure if I can see that, but I will do my best to try. You know what guys, I'm going to take you along for the ride. I have no idea how this will work, but let's melt some solder. Okay, as you can see, everything floated away. So yeah, it melts it pretty damn fast, but sadly you don't really have a good visual clue as when it is melted. So I'm going to have to be extremely careful on that chipset. Yeah, and of course not move it. I moved this just so you can see that it was 100% melted. Of course, this is not the ideal method for this. You want to heat up everything slowly in one piece, not just parts of the board. It's a $2 graphics card. If I can do it like this perfectly, if not, I'm going to throw it away. So let's see. Of course, you can see the plastic melting here. Pretty interesting. Let's do it. Some components left behind. Okay, let's do this. Hopefully I'm not going to kill it, but who knows. this should be enough. But again, no visual clues. I'm just guessing here. If it's not enough, I'm going to try for a bit longer next time. Let's see. The card is in. Let's try to power it on. It could be completely dead now. Who knows? And it doesn't seem to be dead. Let me press F8. It's working. Okay. This thing is bloody working. Of course, let's boot into Windows, but from what I see now, this fixed the card. This really did fix the card. And the heat gun is, I don't know, under $10. Pretty cheap one. It was a discount. It's decently built, but not a known brand. So, yeah. This is pretty good. But let's see when we get to the desktop if we are okay. Yes, we are okay. This is pretty awesome. I'm going to reboot and see when we get to normal Windows with a higher resolution. Yeah, I wasn't seeing colors here. It was almost everything one single color. Let me just show you the card in there. Working happily. So this is pretty neat. And a heat gun like this can be used for many other things. I remove stickers with it, other hard to remove adhesives. Yeah, pretty awesome. You can heat shrink, I don't know how it's called, those tubes that you put on wires when you solder them together. You can use this to heat shrink them. It's working. So this is pretty awesome. I don't know why I'm so happy, because this is a pretty, let's change the resolution. This is a pretty cheap card, but this is the maximum resolution supported by this monitor, so yeah, cannot go above that. It's a pretty cheap card, but this is, how should I say, a proof of concept. It's not really important that I fixed this one, but you can fix more expensive ones like this, or I can fix them. So, yeah. What can I say? Let's see, the driver should be installed without absolutely any issues. Yeah. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Ask anything you need in the comments. Subscribe, check out my other videos, and see you again in the next video. Bye.